As 2018 is tapering off to its end, it's time to throw out the old and put in the new. And the same thing is pretty much going on with the Paradox team as well. Because where is Stellaris going in 2019? Now, for those of you who were watching the Death Clash streams over the last few weeks, you will know that there was an announcement on the last episode. And, well, I'll let Martin Anvert, the game director for the game, say what he had to say.
I will be handing over the position of game director on Stellaris to Daniel, who is taking over effectively pretty much immediately.
Yeah.
Rather effectively a few days ago. And I am still game director at PDS, not of Stellaris. I'm working on something secret.
Yep.
And I am not leaving the company, and this was in plans for a long time. It's not a sudden shift. We internally all knew this was coming. No, I am super confident that the game is in good hands, both with you and with the team. And in that sense, it feels really good to be able to move on from a project and feel, no, this is going to be fine.
So with the departure of Martin and the onboarding of Daniel, the real question is, where is the game going to go with a new game director? Initially, Henrik Ferreus, who was also the lead on Crusader Kings, was part of the original team when it came to game direction. Then it was handed over to Martin Anvert, and now 2.5 years after the game's release cycle, Daniel coming on board. But this obviously does not mean that this is the end of the development cycle of Stellaris. As far as I understand this, the game is wildly successful, completely outstretches games like Crusader Kings, and Crusader Kings itself has already been on the market for quite some time, at least since 2012. 6 years, almost seven, of development. And I would not be surprised if Stellaris is going to continue down the same route, with a long, long tail of new features being added to this game and potentially expanding it into a far larger universe and a far larger canvas for you to play your sci-fi, well, dreams on.
Whenever we get feedback, we have ideas, we sort of put them in these different boxes. And, you know, with Utopia, we sort of tackled the first box, you know, more internal customization, make different empires feel more different from each other. And the big remaining box that we have mentioned before that we haven't tackled yet is obviously diplomacy, which is the big sort of box that we haven't really touched yet. So
at one point, we were planning to do diplomacy before the economy. It's just that I think we realized that the economy would set the fundaments of much, because there's so many more features now in terms of the planets, so many more mechanics to work with, which means you can do so much more diplomacy. Like, now the mechanics are in place for a proper spy system, for all of these things, for economic warfare.
Exactly.
And I think that can just only make the diplomacy expansion stronger, as I remember our reasoning being.
Finally, in the direction of the diplomacy expansion, something that the game does very much need at this point, because, well, right now, you obviously have your planetary economical development, you got your warfare, but the diplomacy kind of boils down to, hey, if you don't attack me, I won't attack you sort of deals. Which is fine, but tacking on a new diplomacy system that is significantly deeper, wider, and just has more features to it is going to give the game a much longer lease on life. The real question is, now that the diplomacy expansion kind of had a soft announcement, obviously this is not official in any sort of regard, but where are we going to go from there? Like, what are the expansion directions that we're going to go into? Are we going to see some more long-term quality of life patching? And it looks like we're going to have some of that.
You know, we're going to try to do a longer period of patching and support off the launch now.
So like a proper bug fixing, quality of life, etc. patch.
Yeah, because we feel like we've been running so fast for so long right now with the project. Like, Stellaris has changed so much in the last 2 years or 2.5 years since the release. We just want to relax a little bit, take some more time to work with tech depth like bugs or performance and stuff like that.
But of course, that doesn't mean more expansions and such aren't coming. Just that now, it's a more of a breather to focus on bugs and bugs performance, AI, quality of life, all of those things.
Yeah, exactly. Because, you know, just getting MegaCorp out there, you get so much more feedback than you would have, just playing it internally. So we're going to figure out like a lot of more things like edge cases and stuff like that we can fix and, adapt things to the newer systems, because maybe we figure out a lot more cool you know, special circumstances that can be adopted better to new systems.
So what would a hypothetical diplomacy expansion entail? What would be the features that we could expect from such a thing? Obviously, there is a large gap in the game right now with diplomacy itself, and there's quite a lot of systems that can be heavily impacted by this. There are such things as the United Galaxy Council, for instance, that had a kind of thing that they were talking about back in 1.2, 1.3, or even some more stuff regarding primitives, etc. So there's quite a lot of stuff that we can actually expect in the future, and where is it going to go to? I really want to see a proper espionage system, something that would make warfare a far more engrossing experience, something that the game I feel is kind of lacking right now. Because sure, a radio outpost that you can see, or a listening post that you can see into another empire's space, is fine, but if that's all you have when it comes to your intel, it's a little bit limited. Of course,
the diplomacy expansion,
yeah,
or a potential diplomacy expansion. There is no,
I mean, I'm not going to talk about anything in detail because...
yeah, of course not.
Like before, we usually don't talk about it that much before, but...
And it's not even certain that there will be a diplomacy expansion, just to be clear. We're not saying that.
Well, it's pretty likely.
It's pretty likely, but we're not announcing anything.
No. In terms of features, just looking at, you know, obvious things like federations, obviously that's something we have to tackle and we want to tackle. So that's something, obviously, that we're looking forward to.
Yeah.
Primitives...
We also talked about sort of a galactic UN before,
yeah,
which sort of a galactic community which could tie into the market and so on. Espionage,
yeah.
Possibly?
Espionage, absolutely, because, you know, like designing an espionage system is sort of a game designer joke. And I've never done it, so I'm still looking forward to designing an espionage system and failing.
I think that would be my one regret. Well, not my one, but one of the things I regret about leaving the project at this point. I didn't get the chance to make a working espionage system or fail horribly.
So there you have it. 2019 is most likely going to be bringing us a form of a diplomacy system, or at least an expansion based around diplomacy, which by itself is rather exciting. I'm really looking forward to see the scope of the game expanding quite significant, and also which features are going to be in any of the free expansions or even the paid ones. But that's, of course, a discussion for the future once it is on the horizon. I'm also very excited about the fact that we're going to see some proper quality of life, as well as see a long period of patching. Now, one can make the argument of, hey, this should have been the game they would have released initially. This is the game I paid for. Hey, I don't necessarily agree with that, because, well, once you bought the game, you knew what you were going to get with your feature set, besides the fact that, you're getting free updates pretty much constantly with the long lifespan of this game. I think it's pretty amazing. So why I can see with some of the arguments there, I kind of think that they are moot, and I think we should all be really happy that this is not a DICE Battlefield-esque product that is dead after 8 months and 2.5 years, almost 3 years now. We're still rocking Stellaris, which is very, very unlikely to see in the industry outside of Paradox Games anyway. But yeah, there it is. 2019 is going to be fascinating. I'm really looking forward to it. What is also going to be cool is the fact that I'm currently running a competition up till December 31st of 2018. You can have the opportunity to win a copy of every single expansion that has ever come out for Stellaris. I have got individual little competitions set up for every single expansion that you can win. All you got to do is find the expansion that you want, sign up for the competition, and of course you can participate in more competition at once. Please be aware that all keys will be delivered on Steam, so please be aware of that, at least Steam key wise. But yeah, you can find more details about that in the description. We're gonna go wrap it up here for today. 2019 is going to be crazy for Stellaris, and finally we will see a game that has all of its fundamentals being completely replaced, from all the way from Utopia till whatever 2.3 or 2.4 is going to be. But we will see in 2019. If you have any ideas of what the changes are going to be, or the systems that you would like to see changed as well, please leave it in the comments below. I'm sure developers or some of the PR staff, social, etc., are reading the comments. I know you are, you cheeky buggers. I know you're out there. I've seen you. But yeah, we're going to go and wrap it up here. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, take care of yourselves, and as always, each other.